basic skills in basketball. Shooting. The first basic skill to be learned is shooting. Every basketball player loves to shoot the ball. The most practiced skill in the game is shooting. Dribbling in basketball is a skill that you should master. It allows you to move around the court while you are in possession of the ball. It is a legal method that allows you to advance with the ball and make a score, as opposed to that of passing it to a teammate to shoot it for the basket. This is how it's done. Dribble the ball with hand and use only the tips of your finger in dribbling it. Employ the wrist and the forearm to push the ball while covering the court. Don't involve the whole hand to avoid losing control of the ball. Don't keep your fingers in touch with each other while dribbling. Spread your fingers to allow full control of the ball as it dribbles. Dribble the ball in one side of your body and not right in front. While dribbling in one hand, use the other hand to drive your defender away from the ball. Passing. Basketball is a team game. By definition, that means all players are involved with the process of playing the game and should function as one. One of the primary skills created to accomplish this is passing. It is a skill that maximizes the involvement of all player in setting up a play to earn successful shots and earn points for the whole team. Basically, there are two types of pass: air pass and bounce pass. Air pass travels between players without hitting the floor. Bounce pass is thrown to the floor so that it bounces to the intended receiver. Air passes include chest pass, a pass that originates from the chest to the receiver's chest level, and overhead pass, a pass that originates from the forehead. With this, the ball bounces right to your receiver. But for better accuracy, you have to experiment by yourself, because the bounce is directly proportional with how strong the ball hits the floor. Rebounding is one of the major aspects of the game. It is your ability to jump with power to gain possession of the ball as it bounces to the rim after a failed shot before it touches the floor. Just how important is rebounding? Whenever you grab a rebound, your team gains a chance to shoot again while the other team actually loses it. Running is one of the basic skills that a basketball player should possess. Because in this sport, speed defines the best. Whether you're on the offensive or defensive side of the game, passing, receiving, shooting or rebounding a ball, you always have to run in any way possible. Here are some tips for you to improve your running skills. Always have a good pair of playing shoes. Always do a combination of dynamic stretching and warm-up activities across the court before going out to play a game. Dynamic stretching. Toe walk. Heel walk. Inch walk. High knees. Butt kicks. Shuffle. Back pedal. Jogging. Karaoke. Jumping jacks.
It is the rare basketball player who can do it all at the highest level. Michael Jordan, Magic Johnson and LeBron James had the ability to handle the ball, pass it, shoot it, rebound and play defense with the best of the best. If you excel at one or two of the five top basketball skills, there will be a place for you on most basketball courts. And if you excel at all five, the sky is the limit. 1. Dribbling. Top point guards dribble and control the ball as if it were on a string. Good technique is critical for a ball handler. You should dribble with your fingertips rather than your palm. Dribble with your head up so you can see the opposition and your teammates. Keep your body low and use your off-ball hand to help keep your defender at bay. Work on dribbling with both hands so you'll be as comfortable going to your left or your right. 2. Passing. Great passers can see the whole court and anticipate where a teammate will go and what a defender will do. Mastering the basics is the place to start. Develop a two-hand chest pass, bounce pass and overhead pass so you can deliver the ball to your teammates in the best position for them to shoot or beat their defender. Steve Nash or Derrick Rose can dazzle you with a behind-the-back or a no-look pass. But those moves are not just for show, they provide a teammate the best chance to score. 3. Shooting. It's difficult to score if you can't shoot the ball effectively. As Better Basketball Coaching explains, shooting is something of an art form, and some players, such as Kevin Durant and Ray Allen, have a knack for it. But everyone can improve their shooting through proper technique and lots of practice. Proper technique includes squaring your body up to the target, shooting the ball with your fingertips, keeping your elbows from flying, putting backspin and arc on the shot, and following through completely after letting the ball fly. 4. Rebounding. Although it helps to be tall and have jumping ability, rebounding is a matter of desire as well as ability. Charles Barkley was relatively small for a forward, but he was an outstanding rebounder. He had the ability to determine where an errant shot was likely to fall, the willingness to crash the boards relentlessly, and the strength to block out taller opponents. 5. Blocking out your opponent, also called boxing out, is one of the keys to good rebounding. To do it effectively, maintain your concentration and focus. Defense. Even the best scorers go into shooting slumps. But you can always play good defense if you hustle and understand both individual and team defense. When you are defending a player, keep your head lower than his. Stay close enough to the offensive player to bother him, but not so close he can blow by you with one step. Know your opponent's tendencies so you can dictate the direction you want him to move. Be aware of the other players on the court so you can play help defense when a teammate loses his man.
Court. Court dimensions. The size of the court depends on the playing level. The size of the court for NBA and college games is 94 feet long and 50 feet wide. It is smaller for high school and junior high. The backboard and rim. The regulation height above the ground for the rim, hoop, is 10 feet, and the rim is 18 inches in diameter. Backboards are 6 feet wide, 72 inches, by 42 inches tall, with the inner square being 24 inches wide by 18 inches tall. The foul line for all size courts. The foul line is 15 feet in front of the backboard. The key is 12 feet wide, and is the same for all basketball courts. The backboard extends 4 feet out over the baseline into the key. A half circle of diameter 6 foot extends from the foul line away from the basket to complete the key. The three-point line, arc, for NBA basketball courts. The three-point arcade is 22 feet to the center of the rim on the sides, with a straight line extending out 16 feet 9 inches from the baseline. Past those points the line extends out 23 feet 9 inches from the center of the rim. Line markings. All line markings on the floor are 2 inches wide and can vary in color. Ball. The basketball is an inflated sphere with an outer covering. It is 75 to 78 centimeters in circumference and weighs 600 to 650 grams. It must be made of leather in the official FIBA competitions. Basket, also called goal. It is made up of horizontal circular metal rim with a net hanging from it. It is mounted 3.05 m above floor level. Backboard, the rigid rectangular board behind the rim. Standard widths are 24-42, 44-48, 60-72. Shoes. High-topped shoes.
Thank you for watching.